numerology, from the word itself, it indicates that on the basis of numbers associated with date of birth. That means, suppose in the date of birth, if someone is having his date of birth something like 29/12/1971. So, there are two concepts these numerologists they work, and that is the first number, that is 2 + 9 = 11. That means this is a number they are associated or they are more interested. Similarly, the total of this number, that means again 2 + 9, that is 2, 1 + 2, that is 3, and 1971 means 10 + 7 = 17, 18. That means 9. 18 means 1 plus 8, that is 9. So, 2 plus 3, 5 plus 9, 14. And ultimately, it comes to 5. So, this is the birth number and this is the lucky number. In real terms, they are called as Janmank and Bhagyank. So, accordingly, these two are the numbers based on which the total analysis goes on. And each number is associated with one particular planet. And accordingly, according to the characteristics of those planets, with some calculations, the forecast is predicted. Now, again, there are people, they have a tendency, or rather because of some incorrect knowledge, they try to mix up Vastu Shastra with numerology. And that is, suppose if someone selects house number 101 and the logic behind this is that 1 + 1 = 2, and this is simply, since this person says that my lucky number, the date, the Janmank or the birth number is 2 and the total of my house number is 2, so it should be lucky to me. Logically it is true, but practically it may not be. Again, look at the points which we have discussed in astrology. There are how many number of persons in your family? So, justice to one or favorism to one, what about the others? And here in the number theory also, each number. Now, suppose if 2 is your birth number, then 5 and 7 are his friendly numbers. So, suppose for him anything, or the house number 401 or 302, which totals to 5, may be positive or beneficial. But again, suppose if father is having number 2 as birth number or number 5 as lucky number, but his wife or his son or daughter, their birth number or lucky number differs. That means, suppose, as I told you, that 2, 5, 7 are friendly numbers. That means, all the other numbers other than 2, 5, 7 are not friendly to these numbers. And suppose, the other family members belongs to those numbers which are not familiar or friendly with 2, 5 or 7. Again, there will be clashes. There will be problems. So, favorism on one side to one and the clashes. So, it is not at all required to go for such confusing states. Here only one thing I would like to suggest, and that is the right approach is, let us see how to go ahead about this. So, simply one with birth number 2, lucky number 5, And suppose if this is, if we follow the selection process, and if they find this is one of the best choice, so according to this, if the house number 101, the total is 2, according to Vastu Shastra, it is best, and it's, if its number is 101, that means as per Vastu Shastra, best, and as per numerology, again matching. This is basically the right choice. That means it is not necessary always when you select the house that the matching of numerology should be there. It is not mandatory at all. Rather, matching of numerology is a bonus to you. Simply, in that case also, even if it is a multi-story and the flat number is 101, or suppose flat number 902, 803 or 704, all these totaling 2, and if they are best as per Vastu Shastra, then it is good. But otherwise, suppose if this is the best and its number is 104 or 20, if it is 103, 203, 303, anyone that is in this row, which is best of the best as per Vastu Shastra, but 1 plus 3, not matching with 2, 5, 203, coincidentally matching with 5, but 303, suppose if this flat is not available, and you have the choice of 103 and 303. So the total here is 4 and here the number, total number is 6. And both these numbers not at all friendly with this 2 and 5. Rather they are enemy numbers. That doesn't mean. See, this is again the numerology is individualistic. Individual based. And Vastu Shastra is for group of people, whether staying together or working at one particular workplace. So, in simply and simply, only one thing you have to remember, if it matches, as a consider as a bonus. If it doesn't matches, you need not to bother at all. Simply ignore and based on Vastu, go ahead and make your decision to purchase and start staying in or start using it. Because Vastu will do its own work. Numerology and astrology, you can encash or get the benefits of numerology or astrology in some other way. whenever and wherever there is a discussion about Vastu Shastra, if it is in India or in the domestic level, naturally, either the comparison of Vastu Shastra with astrology or numerology starts, or nowadays at many places, combining Vastu Shastra with astrology has, or rather becoming a trend day by day. Similarly, even in the domestic market also, one more thing is observed, that those professionals who were already practicing Feng Shui in past, now started practicing in Vastu Shastra, and at many a times, they combined Vastu Shastra and Feng Shui together, which is really horrible or dangerous. Whereas in case of at overseas level, I find because of the influence of Feng Shui, there is always curiosity or a tendency to have a comparison with Vastu Shastra. So, to equip you in this regard properly, let me tell you, or let us have a comparative study of Vastu Shastra, Jyotish Shastra, or Vastu Shastra and astrology, and at the same time Vastu Shastra with Feng Shui. In this regard, let me start with Feng Shui. So let us come to the basic parameters on which Vastu Shastra is based, and on the other side the Feng Shui. And what is the basic difference between these two? Let us come to this. So, in case of Vastu Shastra, and here we will mention about Feng Shui. Vastu Shastra is basically group oriented, whereas Feng Shui is individual oriented. So the first criteria here is group oriented. And this is totally individual based. So, in case of Feng Shui, whosoever the Feng Shui professional visits any particular premises, rather to be very specific about the residential Vastu, first of all, they will take the date of birth or at least year of birth of the in charge of the house. Based on a particular mathematical calculations, they come to or they arrive at a particular number which they term as Kua number, and based on Kua number there is a particular set of arrangement which is totally individual based, and that is definitely for that individual. It definitely helps and gives him better prospects and good success also. But when we talk of a house, house means a family, a group of people. Suppose if we concentrate on one particular individual, that means what about the all other people? If there are four persons in a family, and subject to the Kua number of the main person or the in charge of the house, what about the wife and the kids? When you ask this question to Feng Shui expert, a typical answer you get from that expert will be, we do take into consideration other skua number also. But mind well, it is not the fact, or rather it is not convincing answer. And in that case, I will put it in other word, that justice to one and injustice to others. But whereas in case of Vastu Shastra, there is a proper respect is given to each and every member of the family. If there are 4 persons in a family, or even if you have the 40 people in the family, everyone will be justified perfectly and properly. Because in case of Indian Vastu Shastra, it is the directions and the age of the person and his activities in which he is involved, rather it is his occupation. And that is quite sufficient enough to get him the benefits of Vastu Shastra and thereby make his life perfectly happy and with full of pleasure. Similarly, in case of Vastu Shastra, the 5 elements that are considered, they are the earth, water, fire, air, and space, or it can be termed as sky also. Whereas in case of feng shui, the factors that are considered are definitely, there are earth is there, water is there, which is common, then air is also common with them. But there are 2 other factors instead of the fire and space. They have wood and metal. In case of Vastu Shastra, we have the earth, water, fire, air, and sky or space. Whereas in case of feng shui, they have common with Vastu Shastra, and that is earth, water, air. These 3 are common. But in place of fire and space, they have wood and metal. Remember, in one of the earlier lecture, I have mentioned about the 5 elements on which the Vastu Shastra is based. They are all self-generated. All the 5 elements, that is earth, water, fire, air, and space, they are self-generated. They can neither be manufactured in any of the factory anywhere in the world, nor they can be destroyed on any of the dumping ground, or they can be immersed in any of the sea anywhere in the world. So they are absolutely self-generated. In case of feng shui, I will accept that earth, water and air, yes, they are self-generated. What about wood and metal? Are they self-generated? Can we generate them naturally? No. For wood, someone will have to sow a seed, and then thereby the effect of water, air, fire, earth and the space element, the tree will grow, and from the tree you can get the wood. So it's a creation of nature. Same is the case with metal. You take out a particular ore from the mine and process it. You have to process it, then only the metal can be formed. So these are the creations of the nature with certain process on it. But in case of all the five elements, there is no need for any process, or there is no need to nurture them. So they are longer lasting and they never get destroyed. Wood and metal can be considered as perishable. Wood is definitely perishable, and compared to wood, metal has got longer life. Though metal has a longer life, but still it is perishable, and hence they cannot be considered as longer lasting or non-destroyable. So that is how the Vastu Shastra definitely scores over this. Similarly, there is one concept which we are going to discuss when we start discussion about the Vastu Shastra and its correlation with scientific perspective. Human body is made up of five elements that are mentioned or on which the Indian Vastu Shastra is based. The premises or the dwellings in which we stay or we work, they are also, or rather, they also come from all these five elements on which the Indian Vastu Shastra is based. And the universe, the nature, is full of all these five elements. So naturally, in this case, Indian Vastu Shastra definitely score over the factors that are considered in feng shui. Similarly, the next factor is, in case of Vastu Shastra, when it comes to the factor of mortality, there is no effect. And in case of feng shui, there needs strong need for change. That means, suppose in any particular case, if the in charge of the house leaves this world, or if he dies, anyone from that family who is the senior most takes the charge, and simply the earlier in charge who was occupying the southwest master bedroom, instead of the predecessor, the one who comes in and takes the charge, he can occupy the southwest, and the balance of captainship or the leadership can be restored automatically. Whereas in case of feng shui, if the new in charge comes, naturally based on his kua number, there will be a need for lot of changes. Because if the earlier person, the predecessor, if he is born of 1945, and the successor is born in 1975, naturally the kua number will change, and it is obviously evident or necessary to change accordingly to get the desired effect. So, and whenever you need to go for desired changes in the interior design or the arrangement of the dwellings, whether it is residential or commercial, it can be inconvenient as well as highly expensive also. Whereas in case of Vastu Shastra, everything will remain same except change in the position of master bedroom of the in charge. So, it's absolutely no need for any extra expenses or inconvenience in case of Vastu Shastra. Similarly, in case of Feng Shui, there was no consideration for God. No consideration for the abode of God. Whereas in Indian Vastu Shastra, you have already studied the 10 commandments, and through 10 commandments, you have come to know that the abode of God is definitely very, very important. Of course, here I would like to give you one more correction, that whatever the books you will come across on Feng Shui that are published before 1998, none of the book had any reference about the position of the God or the abode of the God or the importance of the God. I don't know, but after 1998, this particular concept gained a moment, and ultimately they have accepted and modified. But whereas in case of Vastu Shastra, in the earlier session only, we have already discussed how ancient is Indian Vastu Shastra and the references about the God and goddesses is very common, and with due respect to God, rather the position of God helps you in getting the comfort level or pleasant atmosphere in our house. According to Indian Vastu Shastra, presence of God in Northeast. Remember, here the term God I am referring for every religion, whether it is God, Allah, Jesus, whatever may be. The religious sentiments of all the religion or the spiritual sentiments of all religions are considered in one term, and that is what I am using the term God. So, irrespective of the religion, if you get the position of God in Northeast region, it simply helps you in getting the positive spiritual vibrations and energy levels in the house. In case of Feng Shui, when there is no consideration and faith about God, so the concept of spiritual and positive energy level doesn't arise at all or doesn't hold good at all for them. Similarly, by having the God in the Northeast region, we can safeguard our dwellings or premises from all types of negative energy or the demonic forces or evil forces. Whereas in case of Feng Shui, there is no any such provision. So naturally, in case of Indian Vastu Shastra, the presence of God or the consideration of God is very, very important factor. Whereas in case of Feng Shui, there is no provision at all. In addition to this only, in case of Vastu Shastra, Northeast direction is considered as the direction of heavenly forces or heavenly energies come from this direction and southwest is considered as the direction of demonic forces. Whereas in case of feng shui, it is exactly reverse. Northeast is considered as demonic force and southwest is considered as heavenly forces. On this particular statement, I get a question many a times. Though the objective of Vastu Shastra and Feng Shui is one and the same, that is to bring in peace, prosperity and harmony in human life, how these two concepts are working for the same purpose on contradictory parameters? Here in this case, as far as the heavenly forces from northeast and the demonic forces from southwest does have a scientific reasoning about which we are going to study in a very next lecture. Whereas in case of feng shui, the natural energy forces are same as it is mentioned in Vastu Shastra, but through feng shui, whatever the energy they get from southwest, it is channelized in such a manner that ultimately it gets converted into positive and becomes beneficial for the mankind. So, channeling and channelizing the energy and making or converting it into positive is the basic fundamental of feng shui. But simply, I would like to tell you here that when you have the natural energy forces and you can directly use them, why to go for such a lengthy process of converting them into from bad to good or from negative to positive? So, this is one of the another important factors one must take into consideration. Similarly, there is another one parameter, and that is the geographical dimensions. Geographical effect and in case of Vastu Shastra, there is no any impact whereas in case of feng shui, it is highly dependent on geographical conditions. At the same time, we would like to add or combine, there is one more factor which probably will be able to help both these at a time together, and that is Indian Vastu Shastra is a creation of India. Whereas feng shui originates from इंडियन वास्तुशास्त्र। सो दिस सेवंथ पॉइंट आई वुड लाइक टू elaborate first and then I will go to the geographical impact. As you know, in the earlier part only, the ancient text and the references we have already discussed. So I don't think there is any need to explain about Vastu Shastra, the creation of India, or the saints and sages and many researchers of India. In fact, the Indian philosophy or the culture and the knowledge that has been transformed to Eastern countries through Lord Gautam Buddha on his entourage to Eastern countries, whatever the knowledge he has propagated and subject to the geographical condition, the local scholars, they have developed it in such a concept which will be beneficial to the mankind of those countries, and that is feng shui. Because if you look at, now we will come to the earlier part, and that is the geographical conditions. In case of China, where, because from where the feng shui comes, the real originator of feng shui is China. And if you look at the geographical conditions of China, then we come to know that in case of China, on the northeastern side, on the northeast side, they have yellow mountain ranges, yellow river. Because of this yellow river, heavy floods and tornadoes and landslides from the Yellow Mountains leads to lot of or severe impact on the civilization, as well as lot of financial losses they have to incur. Because of this Yellow River and Yellow Mountains, they have to face with floods, tornadoes and landslides. Because of these destructive effects they are facing from northeast region, they have preferred to close the northeastern side, and naturally they have to open up the southwest side. And that is why they have to take all the negative energies to get in, and by channeling them in a proper manner, ultimately they get it converted into positive. Whereas in case of Indian Vastu Shastra, one thing is all the five elements or the eight directions, the basic concepts, they are basically all these five elements are absolutely same and common all over the world. And the approach to use the heavenly energies and stop the or prevent from the demonic energy is applicable universally, except the conditions like China's. Hence, Indian Vastu Shastra is universally applicable, as well as it score over all the different factors of feng shui in a very good manner. In case of feng shui, there are about four different schools of thoughts, like flying star, and there are so many other schools of thoughts. Some of them develop from China, some of them develop from Malaysia, and some of them, even a modified version, comes from Europe also. So at times, which one has to be accepted or which one is more effective also becomes a debatable question. Whereas in case of Indian Vastu Shastra, There is a very simple and common phenomena, and that is 5 elements, 8 directions, and the energy balancing by making use of gravitational, electromagnetic, cosmic and universal energies. And that is why Indian concept of Vastu Shastra will definitely will not create any ambiguity as it is in the case of Feng Shui. Up till now we have discussed about the different parameters or the comparison between the Vastu Shastra and Feng Shui. But in spite of this, some of the experts, especially those who were practicing Feng Shui or still practicing Feng Shui, but have started mixing Vastu Shastra with it. I really don't know, or rather after having a knowledge of all these comparative data or the information, I'm sure you also will be confused how one can work on these two contradictory parameters at the same time in same house or in any same commercial premises. But it is happening, and rather I will say it is simply we are deceiving the people to whom we are providing the services of either Vastu Shastra or maybe of the Feng Shui. So here, because the people don't know about Feng Shui principles and Vastu Shastra principle, hence, and probably they may not be knowing that the consultant or the expert who is guiding them is mixing Vastu Shastra with Feng Shui. So whatever the expert tells or whatever the advice they get from the expert, they accept it. But now we have to restrict it, and we should make the people aware of all these facts. And from all this discussion, you will come to the conclusion that Indian Vastu Shastra is highly effective and superior than all other such sciences. Even I have come across certain cases. In one of the cases where I was analyzing that particular premises, which was a residential premises, and before me some years ago, a Feng Shui consultant has advised them certain things, and to my surprise I saw water fountain in southeast region of that house, and that too as per the advice of the Feng Shui consultant. Remember, as per Vastu Shastra, southeast is a fire element region. Rather, even in case of kitchen, though the gas stove and sink in the and the water element coming together, we have the objection for it. In that case, it is purposely or as a part of the Feng Shui guidance, water fountain was advised and that was there. So on one side, one theory says it is a remedy, but at the same time, the same gentleman, even after doing Feng Shui, is inviting Vastu consultant to advise him. That itself is a self-explanatory that he is not satisfied with the results. In fact, in last so many years since I am practicing, I have got many, or rather hundreds and thousands of cases where Feng Shui was already done, but because of the unsatisfactory results, the people opted for Vastu Shastra. Even I have come across many people who were earlier working as a Feng Shui consultant, but now shifted to, rather I will say, I have many students of mine who were earlier practicing Feng Shui and now then shifted to Indian Vastu Shastra. There is one more thing about this thing I would like to tell you, that I have come across many Feng Shui experts using Shri Yantra. See, it's really how funny the things are. A concept based on Chinese therapy or the Chinese principles, and Shri Yantra is rather the innovation or the creation of Indian spiritual concepts and is used for this. So this is what is the contradiction. Rather, we are mixing two different things which are contradictory. Even I have observed at many places that use of pyramid is also quite common with feng shui, and they have created an impression that pyramid is basically the creation of feng shui. My dear friends, probably in one of the lecture in the last phase, we are going to discuss at length about pyramid. Here only one thing I would like to tell you: pyramid is creation of Indian research. Right from the ancient era, if you look at the structure of temples, or rather the hutments of our saints and sages where they were, or the dwellings of our saints and sages where they were staying, all those had a ceiling in the form of pyramid. Then temples and palaces came. Even after that, I will say, after the Indian culture, civilization, it is the Greek and Roman culture, and there also you will find churches with pyramid on the top of it. Feng shui is the latest creation, hardly maybe about 700 to 800 years back, or at the most 1000 year back. How can they claim the pyramid is their product? In fact, there is one more thing which I would like to add here. In the first decade of this 21st century, the feng shui experts and the media created an impression that Indian Vastu Shastra means totally a destructive concept. Vastu Shastra consultant, when he will visit your house, office or factory, he will simply tell you, break this wall, break this, remove this, install this. That means structural demolition is a part and parcel of Indian Vastu Shastra. Rather, this was a misguiding concept spread by these people. But mind well, now you all being the brand ambassadors of Vastu Shastra, you will have to remove all these misunderstandings and will have to create that impression how Vastu Shastra is superior among all such sciences. And with this, I conclude the comparative study of Vastu Shastra and Feng Shui. Now, let us start our discussion about Vastu Shastra and its correlation with astrology. Coming to the comparative study about the Vastu Shastra and astrology, here one thing is to be taken into consideration that both these metaphysical sciences are absolutely of Indian origin. Both these sciences are interrelated, but they are not interdependent. Remember, this particular statement is very, very important. Both are interrelated, but not interdependent. This is very, very important, but the meaning of this statement you will come to know in this discussion totally. So when it comes to the discussion about astrology and Vastu Shastra, before going into this discussion, let me tell you one more thing, that in India specifically, mixing the astrology with Vastu Shastra is day by day is becoming a trend. Rather, I will say that they are trying to create an impression that without the combination of astrology with Vastu Shastra, it cannot give you the perfect result, which is absolutely wrong. it doesn't hold good true. Because now let us take my own personal example. I have been working in Vastu Shastra for many years, and my organization is today India's one of the largest institute in Vastu Shastra consultancy and education. I have big team of Vastu Shastra expert working, and we have our presence all over the globe. Rather, we have representatives in many countries. My knowledge about astrology is almost nil. If I don't have any knowledge of astrology, in spite of that, I am successful. It is not I am successful. As on date, in last 12 years, we have trained more than 3000 students, and out of them, more than 1200 are practicing as a successful Vastu consultant. Hardly 40 to 50 of them are having the knowledge of astrology, but rest of all 1150 are absolutely and exclusively, they have done studies in Vastu Shastra, and they are all successful in Vastu Shastra. That means if someone is not having a knowledge of astrology, and if he wish to practice in Vastu Shastra, he will be definitely successful, provided he works sincerely, he studies all this concept honestly. So there is no need, number one. Number two, which is very, very important, and that is, in today's lecture only, we have discussed about the ancient references of Vastu Shastra. Except the one particular book I have mentioned in my lecture, and that is Bhrigu Samhita. But remember, I introduced that book as the basic and the most important literature if someone wants to study astrology. The basic guidance book for astrology is Bhrigu Samhita. And why it is useful in Vastu Shastra? It is only to identify which is the auspicious time to start the construction work of the premises, which is the auspicious date, day and time to enter in the new premises, and to deal for certain good things. And that is definitely, finding out the auspicious time is definitely is part and parcel, or rather I will say totally the part and parcel of astrology only. It doesn't have any correlation with Vastu Shastra. So only for that purpose one should refer Bhrigu Samhita, otherwise it is the book of choice for the students of astrology. We had a discussion about hundreds and hundreds of books on Vastu Shastra, and none of them has got mixing with astrology. In other words, all those ancient books and all those ancient scholars and saints of sages have written the separate books on Vastu Shastra and separate books on astrology. If the ancient scholar do not find the mixing of these two is appropriate, why to go for this? Remember, today whatever the knowledge on Vastu Shastra and astrology has come in the form of different books that are available today in the market, that doesn't mean that all whatever is mentioned in those ancient books has come today. Rather, I will say whatever is today we have learned, or whatever the books today in the market giving us the information, is just a tip of iceberg. Tremendous knowledge we still have to explore and practice. And in all these cases, or in all these books, Vastu Shastra and astrology is separately discussed, So there is no need for mixing of these two sciences. The further some of the factors which I am going to discuss are slightly common with the one which we have discussed in comparison with feng shui. In case of astrology, the most important thing is the time of birth and date of birth. Based on the time of birth and the place of birth and its correlation with longitudes and latitudes of the earth, and correspondingly the particular time and place and its correlation with planetary position, based on that our horoscope come into existence. The complete planetary chart for every individual when he comes in this world, rather when he takes the birth, that complete chart is formulated based on the place, date and time, and accordingly the corresponding planetary position decides all these things. And it is absolutely individual based. Rather, the maximum information we get from the horoscope or from the astrological study is absolutely personalized. Of course, through this analysis, we do get some information or some guidelines about your life partner, about your parents, about your in-laws. But that doesn't give the complete history or the detailed information. It provides you some guidelines. So this is what is astrology. Whereas in case of Vastu Shastra, the first and foremost, the differentiating point between these two is Vastu Shastra again can be labeled as group oriented. And Vastu Shastra, and the astrology is totally individualized. Even though if you have a person with the age ranging from 80 years till up to the newly born child, whatever is the number of persons in your family, whether it is 2, 4, 14 or 40, depending upon their age and occupation, different directions are allotted to them, and through different directions and the impact of the elements related, the five among the five elements, whichever the element that is related with that particular direction which is suitable for their age and occupation are given. For example, the elderly persons, the retired persons are asked to sleep or asked to have or advised to have their master bedroom in northeast. Whereas the children and the guests are advised to have their master bedroom in northwest. And the in charge of the family is definitely supposed to sleep in southwest. Here also, Vastu Shastra is highly comprehensive enough that it does mention you that if you are on the verge of retirement, or if you are due, or if you are already retired, you should leave the southwest master bedroom, or rather you should allot that master bedroom to your elder son, and then you should occupy the northeast bedroom. So that the stability, leadership, all these factors which we will discuss when we will discuss the direction of southwest, and when we will discuss about the master bedroom, all these things will come to you properly. So this means, or rather what I wanted to suggest you, that Vastu Shastra is highly comprehensive enough and sufficient enough to take care of all the members of the house. Number two, here on this basis only, even if you take into consideration the date of birth or the horoscope of the in charge of the house, and based on that if you select any particular house, because in Vastu Shastra when we will discuss about the different characteristics of the directions, each direction has got some correlation, or rather I will say each direction is governed by a particular planet. For example, the ruling planet of east is Sun. Ruling planet of southeast is Venus. Then ruling planet of south, Mars. Or ruling planet of north, Mercury. So every direction has got a particular ruling planet. And suppose, for example, if a person, according to his horoscope, if the based on his zodiac sign, because even the directions do have zodiac signs, that doesn't mean if this is the only relationship between the Vastu Shastra and astrology, that doesn't mean suppose a person, according to his horoscope, if his ruling planet is Mars, that doesn't mean that he should stay in south, the house with south entrance. It may be logically true. It will definitely, a person with Mars as a ruling planet in his horoscope, if he opt for south entrance, no doubt it will be useful and beneficial to him. But do you think that the other members in the family will all be having Mars as a favorable or comfortable or strong planet in their horoscope? So this means one planet favorable for one individual in the family may not be hold goods true or the same favorable to all other members. Suppose if someone, or rather the in charge of the family, is under the influence of negative period of the Saturn of that 7.5 years, he will be in trouble. That doesn't mean his wife or his kids also will get affected. Not at all. Because every individual's horoscope is absolutely different. And suppose if you go for, on the basis of horoscope of an individual, and then accordingly if you select the house and make the interior arrangement, this will be again create justice to one, injustice to all other. So based on the place of birth, date of birth and time of birth and corresponding planetary position decides the horoscope, rather the fate and destiny part of any individual. If there are number of persons in family, maybe 3, 4, 5, whatever may be, everyone's date of birth, place of birth, time of birth and corresponding planetary positions are bound to be different. And in such cases, simply by working on the astrological chart of one individual, that simply indicates justice to one, injustice to others. Even if one insists on the horoscope or the astro chart of an individual or in charge of the family and go for the selection of Vastu or the interior arrangement of the Vastu according to his horoscope, but in a family, if there is a husband, wife and kids, and along with the husband, if the wife is also a professional, children are well grown and likely to enter in the competitive studies or in professional studies or ready to take up the career. Under such circumstances, again, this type of arrangement may create obstacles or may not be able to provide the favorable atmosphere for the growth and development of other members of the family, which they are entitled to get through Vastu Shastra. So that is why it is always mandatory, or as a best approach, one should always do or select your vastu absolutely on vastu shastra, and based on the basic fundamental principles of vastu shastra, you can allocate master bedroom for the master in southwest. Depending upon the age of the children, they can be allotted master bedroom in northwest, and if at all if there is any other bedroom in south or west, naturally the first preference to go for the elderly children's, and north is bedroom for elderly people or rather senior citizens or the parents in family. And same is definitely applicable for the position of God or the abode of God in northeast, living room in the northwest, north, northeast region, kitchen in the southeast, which will simply get the best of best effects to each and every individual on the basis of Vastu Shastra. Because all the directions, all the five elements work equally for each and every individual, irrespective of his age, his occupation, and even his religion. So, based on Vastu Shastra, which is highly comprehensive enough, you take the advantage or the best effect of Vastu Shastra first, and then, in spite of this, if someone still persists with or continues with the problems he come across, then in the case of that particular individual, you can simply have the analysis of his horoscope, and if at all if there are any problem, if you come across through that analysis, it's simply you can have the corrective measures and can get the good benefits or the best effects. So in general, first one should adopt and apply the Vastu principles, and then for the individual's benefit, one can go for astrology. Though Vastu Shastra and astrology are interrelated, but they are not interdependent. Please remember this thing, and that is why no combination or mixing of astrology with Vastu Shastra is at all required. Lastly, there is another one difference, or rather I will say one of the point which definitely score over astrology, and that is in case of Vastu Shastra, there is one line of thought process. There is a one basic set of principles which is applicable universally and to all the people, irrespective of caste and creed, because it works on natural forces, and natural forces are always for mankind and not for any religion. In case of astrology, there are 12 different type of subjects or theories or concepts related with astrology. One of them is basically the traditional pattern of astrological studies. Then comes the Krishnamurti pattern of astrological studies. Then face reading, then palmistry, numerology, Ramal science, and like that, there are different theories, including the knowledge of stones, precious and semi-precious stones, and etc. Likewise, the systems of interpretation with traditional astrology and Krishnamurti pattern astrology are different, and many a times even the conclusions or the forecast we get from these two vary with accuracy. Same is true with numerology also. The interpretation method, the analysis method is different, and accordingly there are many factors which are common in forecast, but sometimes there are chances of variations. So this way, astrology, there are number of systems, but in case of Vastu Shastra,
there is only one thought of system and it is applicable to all age group.
With this, I will say one should again remember the difference between Vastu Shastra and astrology, and please, please remember there is no need at all to mix up astrology with Vastu Shastra or vice versa. Even though I come across many of my students who have already a background of astrological study or astrological profession, but the moment they come in this class, I simply, or rather this is a instruction and a warning to all of you, whenever you are going to practice, if it is Vastu Shastra, please make it exclusively Vastu Shastra. And if it is you are handling any astro case, simply and exclusively, you have to concentrate and tackle the case only on astrological parameters. There should not be any intermixing of these two.